Hi everyone, Robin here. In this series of videos, I'll dive deep into the latest updates and features in Final Cut Pro Motion and Compressor. Expect the usual juicy details, tips and tricks, many of which I'm willing to bet you won't see anywhere else. Welcome back. In this series of videos, all of which you can check out in this playlist up here, we'll explore both big and small features and surprising improvements in the latest update, such as the enhanced light and color function, the machine learning enhanced smooth slow-mo for retiming clips, new search options for finding missing media effects and more in your timeline, improved effects controls, and an overview of compressor and spatial video. Remember, for all of this, you'll need at least Final Cut Pro 10.8 and at least macOS Ventura 13.5. Let's kick things off with some interesting new improvements to the scrolling timeline and titles. So I recently made a comprehensive video covering all aspects of the then new and seemingly mundane auto-scrolling timeline when it came out. I even made an addendum to it because I realized I had missed a few things that I thought were important, pointing out certain features that I absolutely loved, as well as aspects that I thought could use some improvement. And while there's a link in the description, as they say, to both, a lot of what I talked about is now more or less obsolete. Thanks, Apple? Yes, actually, it's like someone was taking notes because it has gotten even better since they seem to have addressed every one of my little niggles. So, what has changed? First of all, I said,
to activate it, you simply go into the Final Cut settings and under the Playback tab. And here you'll find a new checkbox at the very top of the playback section for scroll timeline continuously during playback.
Well, that is no longer there. But rather, if I close the settings window and look at the top right of my timeline, you'll see a new button next to the skimmer button has appeared. Yes, a button. As I mentioned in the addendum video,
some of the comments I got on the first video made me realize my first omission, where some were saying that it's too bad that there's no easy or quick on-off switch.
So something others ask for as well. In the same video, I point out that there may not have been a button, but
because there is, in fact, a new freely assignable keyboard command for the scrolling. If you open the command editor with Alt-Command-K and enter scroll in the search field, you'll see the timeline scrolling command listed, which has no shortcut assigned by default. To assign it a shortcut, you simply select it, select or create a custom command configuration, and enter the desired shortcut on your keyboard.
And guess what? When I hover my mouse over the button until the tooltip appears, bingo. You can see that even the exact shortcut I suggested is now the default, Alt-Shift-S. And it's probably worth repeating from the other video that you won't have this new shortcut if you're on a custom keyboard layout, as it won't have existed when you originally set it up. The command itself will of course be added, just not any of the new shortcuts. So you can either switch back to the default layout or simply add your own shortcut in the command editor. What else has been changed or improved? Well, for one of the things I thought was less than ideal was the fact that
if I want to jump ahead further than the current zoom level can fit into the window. In other words, if I want to scroll to the left past the position of the playhead so it's not visible anymore, well, it starts doing what annoys me so much about the way others have implemented this. It doesn't allow me to scroll to the right any further when the playhead hits the left edge of the window.
And how has that changed? Well, you can now scroll freely in either direction without any restrictions while it's active, once again making it that much better than any other scrolling timeline. So while it's playing, I can use my magic mouse to scroll in either direction to maybe check something I just watched or something that is coming up. But as I pointed out in my previous video, if you want to make adjustments without it jumping back to center the playhead, you'll have to have the clip skimmer active and float the mouse over a clip.
Und wie generiert man aktive emotionale Interaktion zielgerichtet?
Pretty cool. So no one can tell me that Apple isn't listening. And speaking of scrolling in either direction, one of the smaller changes is that while I showed...
If you hit the J key to play backwards and the playhead reaches the left of the timeline, it auto-scrolls to the right.
If you hit J to play backward now, you don't have to wait for the playhead to hit the left side of your timeline. The playhead now stays centered going backward too. One of them little things, but nice. Then there are also some new additions to the only recently introduced dynamic titles and generators themes, as well as a couple of new categories. First off, there's a basic text category that, once again, in my opinion, has some more deceptively simple but very useful additions. Basically, a collection of three basic titles, either with or without a background, plus two lower third titles. Where in the ones with a background, you have some nice options, for example, to turn the background off or change its color, blur the underlying video, or even dim it during the title. And all of them have the option to add a backplate to the text whose corners can be rounded, its color changed or opacity reduced, as well as several animation options. And almost all of these are also made with a paragraph type text box that is aligned within the action safe area of the viewer. That means you can use the simple text title to quickly and easily make some classic burned-in style subtitles, for example. You simply enter the text that you want, set the alignment to the bottom, turn on the backplate, change the appearance to your liking, and you're ready to go. And all of them are, of course, perfectly compatible with vertical formats and conform accordingly. The dynamic titles category has gotten an additional set of titles under the theme Deco, which is nice. For which there is, of course, also a new transition that goes with it stylistically. Something I missed with a more recent update concerning the Essential Titles category is that rather elaborate Essential Timecode and Essential Slate titles have been added, both with a lot of useful options for customization. And last but not least, the Dynamic Backgrounds category has gotten six new glitch-style backgrounds, which are also pretty cool-looking. Unfortunately, as I mentioned in one of my previous videos, none of which have any color customization options. So, again, one would have to either use the colorize filter or one of the other color filters to push it in a different direction if needed. And once again, all of these are also perfectly compatible with and conform to vertical formats. So, what do you think of these detailed improvements? Do you use the scrolling timeline and appreciate the changes as much as I do? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments. And if you're curious about how Final Cut's scrolling timeline compares to those in Premiere and Resolve, and why I think theirs can be literally dangerous, check out my previous videos over here or from the links in the description. Thank you for watching. If you found this video useful to learn something new, there's even more content in the playlist. And remember, this video is sponsored by me. Your support keeps the channel running, so maybe consider liking and subscribing. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Take care.